Hello, welcome viewers. Today's class is regarding diffraction of light and also the greenhouse effect. What is diffraction of light? Diffraction is defined as the bending of waves around the corners of the obstacles or through an aperture into the region of shadow. Diffraction of light is occurring when light waves encounters an obstacle or narrow path or narrow lines like gratings or slit. You can see diffraction that is performed by a grating. In the figure you can see the diffraction taking place, and through the grating the waves are coming here, and there is no diffraction, it would have gone through this way. But on closer observation you can see that the red color is maximum deviated from this main original path, and on both sides red color maximum, and closely you can see the whip jar, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red colors are there, and here maximum deviation. Do you agree that the red color is on both sides maximum deviated, but violet color is very less deviated? But see the example of another example here of a prism. But you can see in the prism the original white light is going through this way. This is the path of the white light. If there is no diffraction, it should have gone like this. But the red color is showing minimum deviation and violet color is showing maximum deviation. Can you explain why a diffraction grating and prism are behaving like this? Entirely different. Is it a correct explanation? Here in a prism, violet is maximum deviated from the original line, and red color minimum deviation. You can see violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red in this way. These are two diffraction cases. Grating is produced by very close fine lines on either a glass or metal sheet. Okay, you know that. And why the diffraction of light? What is diffraction of light? Diffraction is defined as the bending of waves around the corners of obstacles through an aperture into a region of shadow. Diffraction of light is occurring when light waves encounters an obstacle or narrow path like a grating or slit. So we have seen diffraction grating through which the rainbow colors are produced bypassing the whip jar colors on either side are produced just like a mirror image. On just assume that this is a mirror plane, then you can see on both sides they are equally disposed, and various other designs can be created using diffraction. When a beam of light through a narrow slit is allowed to fall on diffraction grating, we can see the whip jar spectrum due to diffraction. After passing through the diffraction grating, the red color is showing maximum deviation and violet color minimum deviation from the original light, or deviation increases in the order from violet to red. Red is showing maximum deviation and violet minimum deviation of colors. We have seen diffraction through a prism, and in this case it's the original path of the white light. Then after entering into the prism, the red color minimum deviation and violet color maximum deviation. Same thing as the spectra. When white light is passing through prism, after passing through a prism, the red color is showing minimum deviation in the case of prism, and wild color maximum deviation and from the original white light. What deviation decreases in the order of violet minimum and red maximum of the Wibbshire colors. We have to think aloud why there is a discrepancy in diffraction in the two cases, and next class I will come with the answer. You just think about this. Meanwhile, we have a topic called greenhouse effect. Nowadays we are very much concerned about environment, and environment education is a part and parcel of every course from the nursery class to postgraduate level. As we know, environmental education is all activities concerned related to the sustainable development of Mother Earth. You can see in the figure, from the sun, rays are coming to the earth. Infrared rays are also, along with the visible ultraviolet and infrared rays, are coming here. In the atmosphere, air molecules are there. The air molecule will contain especially the greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, and water vapor and ammonia, etc. These molecules listed as water vapor, ammonia, carbon dioxide, nitric oxide, etc., molecules having methane, etc., having special character of absorbing infrared radiation and keeping it. Actually, during the sun, daytime, the sun rays are coming and the surrounding air of our earth is absorbing the radiation and is not releasing. The result is that during night time, these gases will work as a blanket and the energy is not dissipated fully. They are utilizing the energy for rotation and vibration purposes. And our atmosphere is not very cool soon after darkness. This is due to the greenhouse gases. That we want to have some knowledge about the greenhouse gas. In the figure you can see a greenhouse effect, that is the molecules are absorbing and they are again transferring the same energy to the ground and thereby working as a blanket. What is greenhouse effect? The atmosphere which is almost transparent to radiations or visible radiation, but almost opaque to infrared radiation. Almost transparent means whenever the visible rays are falling on it, it will pass through it, or it will reflect from the surface of earth and will go outside. But it is not the case of infrared radiation. Infrared radiation will contribute its energy towards stretching and bending vibration of such asymmetric molecules, or asymmetry due to various reasons. They will contribute the energy for stretching vibration, bending vibration, etc. Greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, N2O, that is nitrous oxide, NO2 is nitrogen peroxide, and methane, CH4, water vapor, ammonia, etc. The water vapor is in percent the cloud. Everybody will be feeling that situation. When cloudy atmosphere is there, we will feel more hot because the temperature is increasing, because the water vapor is not releasing whatever the infrared radiation is absorbed. It is utilizing for stretching and bending vibration, and the energy is not dissipated from such molecules. They absorb infrared radiation and prevent IR rays to pass through them. And these gases keep the earth's surface warm even during night. Greenhouse effect is the process by which radiation from the planet's atmosphere warms the planet's surface to a temperature higher than in the absence of greenhouse gases. So it will keep on warming the atmosphere, and that is called a greenhouse effect and greenhouse gases. The list you may be remembering: carbon dioxide, NO2, that is nitrogen peroxide, N2O, nitrous oxide, CH4, methane, NH3, ammonia gas, water vapor, H2O vapor, that is present in cloud, etc. They are mainly the greenhouse gases. With this, we'll stop today's class. We'll come with more details about the diffraction and greenhouse effect and how they are related in the coming classes. Thank you for listening. If you find this video useful, do subscribe.